discovering my aesthetic videos because my refund for the other one finally came through, and I really enjoyed filming this last time, and I know a lot of people enjoyed watching them, so I thought I would do another one. I've basically got two bags. I got this absolutely enormous one here, this smaller one, because I think ASOS didn't want to send me a cardboard box like last time. They sent me it in bags, so the shoe box came separately. I had a whole faff because the delivery driver didn't actually deliver it to my flat. I had to go and try and find it from my neighbours, and then thankfully one of them got my little note that I like rammed through their letterbox saying that I was missing a parcel. But it's all here now, thankfully. And I figure I would just crack on with it straight away. I look like a bit of a mess because I wasn't planning on filming this today. But as soon as it's all here now, I kind of want to just get it done with. If I'm talking a bit weird, it's because I've just like done some teeth whitening, and like I can feel my teeth. I don't know if anyone else has ever had this before, but when you do teeth whitening, like they get a little bit sensitive and you notice that they're there, whereas normally I don't feel like I recognise my teeth in my mouth. I don't know how to explain that, it sounds like such a weird thought, but there we go. I'm going to really quickly open this all out because I'm sick and tired of having to edit out little individual clips of me talking over plastic. Okay, so I've now opened everything out. I've got my pile of clothes next to here. I don't know if you'll be able to see this on camera or not, but they're here. It's an absolute tower. Like, I am so impressed. And if you don't know me, if you don't follow me on Instagram, if you haven't watched my channel for a while, you'll know that I absolutely love black clothing. And I wanted to film this video like before I did the classic academia, because while that one was really fun and I enjoyed trying on all the different stuff, I don't wear white clothes, white or light clothes, I don't really do it, because I'm quite messy, for one, I'm quite messy, and I feel like black hides a multitude of sins, let's just say, so I'm most comfortable wearing black clothing. So when Heather said to me about filming this one and doing Dark Academia, I was like, let's do it, because I know you're going to pick out loads of black clothing and I'm all for that. This is a mountain of dark greys, blacks and browns, so I'm mega chuffed with this already. I'm just hoping that this stuff like fits me and looks nice, because I actually want to keep some of this stuff, even just from taking these out of the packet. They all feel ridiculously soft, and I'm so excited for it. I'm just going to start, I'm going to get on with it. Obviously all of these are from ASOS, that's what I did the last haul on. I love doing this on ASOS because then you get a wider range of things from different brands, so Heather really got to go ham basically on what she was picking. The first thing is a jumper dress. I'll do try on clips as well and insert these without me talking through them this time, I'll talk through my opinions now. This is from Only, I'd never heard of that brand before, and Heather got it in a size small. It's like a knitted, like quite stretchy, really soft jumper dress. And it's got a high neck, like roll neck sort of thing going on, which I quite like as well. That's very my style. I feel like Heather knew what she was doing when she picked this up. I think this is going to be really cozy. I kind of wish I'd got a belt, because I'm living with my boyfriend at the moment, like I said in my last video. I don't really have a lot of my stuff here, and I definitely don't have a belt with me. So maybe I might have to see if Dan has one that I can pinch just to belt this in, because it does look quite wide. I'm not sure whether that'll be too flattering on me or not, but we'll give it a go. That was really nice. I won't be putting prices or anything up, because I personally don't know what the prices were to these. Heather put everything in the basket and I just ordered it for the sake of this video. Like, I didn't go through looking and, you know, that was too expensive, find a different one, that's too cheap, find a different one. I just went with what Heather picked. I did that in the last time I did it. Heather. Her name's Heather, maybe. We've been friends for a while now. Know her name. The next is another grey jumper. This is like the last video. There was like a nude brown one. I think this one's from Stradivarius. Oh no, this is Collusion. Okay. But it's like that kind of, like, quite slim fitting. But this is like charcoal grey. I love it already. Roll down neck again. I like Collusion, it's the unisex brand that they have on ASOS. I think their clothes are always really good quality, they're always really affordable as well. And they just look smart. Like, anything I've ever had from Collusion just looks, it looks good. I don't know what else to say about it, it looks good. Oh, my pile's just fallen over. I'm quite worried about this because it does look a bit see-through, and I don't tend to wear jumpers with tops on underneath. But I'll give it a go. It's also not very long as well, that looks kind of like crop length. So for me being quite short, it'll probably sit around my waist. This next thing I'm really excited for, this is a coat, it's a size 10. It's from QED London. I've heard of them, don't know if I said that right or not, I think it's London. And it's like a knitted wool coat with like a silk inner. I don't know how to explain that. I'm just hoping this won't be too long on me, because I am petite. Shoulder pads in it as well, love a good shoulder pad. I am like 5'3, 5'4, and so I have issues with getting longer coats to fit me because they need to fall like literally like mid-thigh for me for it to look flattering. Because if I have it too long, I look really tiny. If I have it too short, I look really stocky because I've got quite a big bust as well. There's loads of things to factor in. So I'm glad Heather got this in a size 10 because that means it's going to be oversized. So I've got a better chance of it actually fitting me on my top half. But yeah, it may be slightly too long. I'm just excited to have a coat, to be honest, in this video. I love coats. I love trying on coats. They're like my favourite thing to go shopping for, especially online. That is all the grey done. I'm quite proud I got all that done in one go. And now let's move on to the black. So this is another high neck jumper. Heather knows me so well. This is just, I feel like she's just picked out my wardrobe for me from ASOS. This one is from, this is another Collusion one. I think this is the same, oh it's a dress, oh okay. It's like the same material as the grey one, so again like a thin knit that you can kind of see through, wouldn't be too warm. It's a jumper dress, it's quite long. I'm just going to sort of stick my legs out on the bed. I think this, by the looks of it, is going to come down to like below my knees. It's quite nice. It feels like the material, my mum used to buy George cardigans when I was a kid and she'd wear them all the time to work, and it kind of feels like that material, kind of like not a soft knit, but it's not scratchy either, it's just sturdy. I'm gonna say that's like a sturdy thin knit. It's quite nice. Next up we've got this pearl cardigan thing, which I think is so freaking cool. I think this is from Mango, like based on the label. It doesn't say, it just says MNG on it, and I don't know if that's, that is that, basically. This is really cute, it's cropped, it's got these pearls on it, they are kind of nipple placement, so I don't know how I feel about that. I'm hoping when I wear it they won't be, but they're cool, like the buttons are cool. And they're not, they're difficult, they're a little bit difficult to undo. Not massively, but I suppose that's good because then you're not going to have a nip slip anytime soon because they'll be firmly done up, and now I can't do it back up, so there we go. This is like Zara jumpers, if anyone knows what I mean. Like the thick, soft, like kind of elastic but not too elastic material that Zara always does their jumpers in. That's what that is, like really sturdy, definitely not see-through. And I have a feeling I'm going to fall in love with this because V-necks as well are kind of like my thing at the moment. I might even layer this, I'm not really sure. I might put like a high neck underneath this, we'll see. I don't know what I'm going to do. I, again, like the last video, didn't do any outfit building for this, neither did Heather. She just sort of put everything in the basket and I was like, yeah, this is amazing, let's go with this. And then I haven't planned what I'm going to be doing with any of it, so we'll find out. I got some trousers, thankfully, because there's loads of tops in there. I think this may be the only pair of trousers in the haul. I think these are the only ones. So again, I think this is from Mango, it's their MNG again. I think they must have rebranded, but I've only ever bought one thing from Mango, so I would not know. They are like the black trousers from the last haul, but ever so slightly starchier, like there's no elasticity to them at all. They're quite thick. They've got that like, I don't know how to explain it, but that feel to them, if that makes any sense. And it's got the double button clippy thing, but this one's really thick, which is cool. I think, I have a feeling these may be too small, but then again, I have no clue what size I am right now. So they could fit me, they may not. We will find out in the try on bit. Next is tissue paper. And, oh, this one Heather tried to put this into the last haul, and I actually removed it from the basket, so I was like, no, I swear I've got something similar, and I don't. It's just because it was a high neck, and I was like, yeah, no, I've got that. Basically, it's a black high neck jumper, but it's got this massive cutout in the back. I don't know if you can see that very well. This huge cutout here, and like high neck in the front and all this. But then the back is completely open, which I thought was really cool. This is the softest thing in this order as well, just to put that out there. This is really, really freaking soft. And it's kind of got like a little puff shoulder as well, like seam, I don't know how to explain that. It's got like a little, I don't know, it's quite feminine, it's just a little on your shoulder. And I can't find a tag for it, so I can't tell you where it's from. I think this may be ASOS own brand though. I'm just gonna have a rifle. Yeah, okay, that's ASOS own brand for that one. That's really nice. It's quite long though, so I'm definitely gonna have to tuck this in. I'll give it a go. We'll see how that works. I don't know what's... I think this is like the final top. It's another, you guessed it, it's another black high neck. This is from QED London again. It's got proper puff sleeves, like the other one was quite muted. These are like proper, I can tell these are gonna stand up when I've got this on. The high neck isn't like a roll neck like the rest of them. This is just like a subtle kind of turtleneck where you don't roll it down or anything. It just sits on your neck, which I love. That is the neckline that I find really flattering on me. Again, it's kind of like a crop length. The material feels really nice. It feels like if you've ever owned a jumper from Quiz, random but specific, it feels like that material from Quiz. Don't know how else to put it. It comes in at the bottom and I'm hoping it will be comfy. So last for like clothing items, Heather picked me up some scarves. She got this gigantic like brown scarf from Monkey, which I'm gonna put on now because it looks deliciously warm. It's really, really soft. It's probably gonna give me static hair. Oh my god. You know when you just want to put a scarf on? Like even if you're indoors and it's like, oh, it's like a fluffy little blanket. I'm gonna keep this one on while I talk about the next one. But this is nice. I tend to get my scarves from Primark for like £4, so I've got the really soft ones, but they're really thin, so they don't really do anything. But this is nice. This is like silky as well, big fluffy silky. Okay, and then the second scarf is again a brown one. This one I kind of had some input on. Heather showed me like 3 tartan ones and I picked this one. This one's from Pieces, and again it's really soft. I haven't just put another one on, I just put this on my shoulders. Oh, but this is like this is a lot thinner than this brown one. I realise I must look like a freak right now, but we're just going with it because my flat's really cold. I like the pattern on this one more though. I kind of feel like the tartan looks better than the plain brown. Oh god, I'm so staticky. Ugh. But we'll have to see, I think, with the outfits, how that goes. Because obviously, like, the coat that Heather picked up is grey. So I don't know whether the tartan will go better with the grey or... or whether the brown one will. So we'll find out. I'm really excited for these because Heather also bought herself a pair of these, and I don't think these are my size straight off the bat. Oh no, supposedly they are. Okay, these look giant for a size 4. I don't know how I feel about this. These look huge. Okay, so Heather bought herself a pair of these as well, and they are from Mango again. Again, I really am praying that MNG is Mango because I've been saying it for this whole haul. That looks giant for a size 4 shoe, I'm sorry. But it looks massive, it's cool. It's like this like silky leather boot. Like, it feels quite thin, the leather. I don't know if it's real or not. And it's got a pointed toe on it as well. And then like a block heel, it's not too chunky. It's really lightweight though. A lot of the boots I own are quite heavy. So I'm excited to see how this goes. I'm just gonna show you these like this because I'm probably not going to be able to get them in the actual videos, but these are the boots. I don't know how I feel about them. They're so comfy, like ridiculously comfy. They're so stretchy and like the sole isn't solid, so it like moves as you walk, which is really nice. Please excuse the cable, I'm basically holding my ring light as a light because it's really late now that I'm filming this. But I don't know, they just feel really witchy. I've got them on with the mango trousers right now, and obviously like the trousers are too long for them as well. So I don't know if that doesn't help, but I've got quite skinny feet and I think it just really accentuates that, which is not, it doesn't really work in proportion to me, and the heel is really far back as well. So yeah, I don't know how I feel about them.
I've been having some trouble with my feet recently and like foot pain and stuff. So whether I can walk in these or not is a whole different story, but yeah, I'm excited to get to it. So I'm gonna put like a try on section in now. Or no, I'll have put a try on section in with all of these as I've gone along. So I'm gonna film that now and then I'll give you my opinions afterwards. But hopefully all of these look good. So thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed. I'm definitely going to do more of these. I want to do Y2K, I think that's what it is, or e-girls next. So I'll do, if you follow me on Instagram, and then probably within the next week, or once the refund from this stuff comes through, once I decide what I'm going to keep and what I'm not going to keep comes through, then I'll do the poll on my Instagram story, and then you can decide whether you want e-girl, aesthetic or aesthetic, or Y2K aesthetic next. But I'm excited for this. I do really enjoy doing this because I like realizing how different my style is to a lot of different people, and how much I really love the comeback. So we're gonna go with that. I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.